Pivot tables are powerful tools for summarizing and analyzing both small and large amounts of data. In an Excel pivot table, you can use custom formulas to create calculated fields and calculated items to extend what you can do with your base data, which becomes especially important when working on large data sets. A lot of you may have difficulty understanding the key difference between calculated fields and calculated items. In this tutorial, we understand the main differences with the help of examples. Calculated fields within pivot tables allow users to create custom calculations. This means you can develop your special metrics, ratios, and summaries that go beyond what the raw data shows. In the Excel pivot table, the calculated field is like all other fields of your pivot table, but they don't exist in the source data. But they are created by using formulas in the pivot table. Firstly, we need a simple pivot table to add a calculated field. To create a pivot table, convert your data into an Excel table. To do this, select all the data, go to the Insert tab, and click Table. Or use shortcut Ctrl plus T, select any cell in the data table, and then go to the Insert tab, click on Pivot Table. We can also use a shortcut to Insert Pivot Table, Alt plus D plus P. This will open the Create Pivot Table window. Choose the target location for your Excel pivot table. We have two options, new worksheet or existing worksheet. I will insert a new worksheet. Click OK. Let's add fields to the pivot table. Just click on any of the fields in your pivot table. You will see a pivot table analyze tab in your ribbon. Click on fields, items, and sets. You will further get a list of options. Just click on the calculated field. After clicking the calculated field, you will get a pop-up menu. This pop-up menu comes with two input options, name, formula, and selection option. Name of the calculated field, which will show in your pivot table. The formula is an input option to insert the formula for a calculated field. Fields is a drop-down option to select other fields from source data to calculate a new field. We have the salary and bonus percentages for every department. We need to add another column to calculate the new salary with bonus. First, type a unique name for the calculated field in this example. The new calculated field is named Employee Bonus. Type the bonus calculation formula. Instead of typing field names, you can double-click on them in the fields list below the formula box. Click the Add button to save the new field. The new calculated field is added to the fields list in the dialog box below the existing fields. The field was added to the pivot table. To adjust the formatting of your data, simply press Ctrl plus 1 and choose the data format. Let's have a more complex calculated field example. We'll create a calculated field that uses annual salary and years in company fields to determine whether the person will get the bonus with the help of the if function. The employee will get a bonus if they have stayed with the company longer than 10 years. We will follow the same steps to open the Insert Calculated Field dialog box. Type a name for the calculated field. In the formula box, type the if formula that refers to annual salary and years in company fields. Click Add to save the calculated field, then click Close. The employee bonus field appears in the values area of the pivot table. To adjust the formatting of your data, simply press Ctrl plus 1. And choose the data format. If you no longer need the calculated field, you can delete it. Select any cell in the pivot table. On the ribbon, click the Analyze tab, click on Fields, items, and sets. Click Calculated field. From the fields list, select the name of the calculated field you want to delete. Calculated items are like all other items of your pivot table, but the difference is that they are not in existence in your source data. They are just created by using a formula. You can edit, change, or delete calculated items as per your requirement. Firstly, to create a pivot table, convert your data into an Excel table. Use shortcut Ctrl plus T. Select any cell in the data table, and then go to the Insert tab, click on the pivot table. Add the pivot table to a new sheet. Pivot table calculated items allow you to do mathematical calculations with your item list. You can use any of the Excel mathematical operators. The only limitation is that you cannot reference any cells. Pivot table calculated items can be used to calculate changes between each other, like a month's or year's value, averages, or summations. Working with calculated items, it is important to remember that you cannot refer to the pivot table totals or subtotals. A calculated item becomes an item in a pivot field. The individual records in the source data are calculated, and then the results are summed up. Calculated items are listed with other items in the row or column area of the pivot table. Calculated items are not shown in the pivot table field list. Fields that contain a calculated item cannot be moved to the report filters area. If any field contains a calculated item, you cannot add multiple copies of any field to the values area. For example, you could not add quantity twice to show the min and max values. We have sales data. I want to calculate the revenue difference between two product categories, drinks and bakeware. To adjust the formatting of your data, simply press Ctrl plus 1 and choose the data format. To insert calculated items, in the pivot table, select a cell that contains product categories. Click on the Analyze tab, then on Fields, Items, and Sets. Click on Calculated Item. After clicking the calculated item, you will get a pop-up menu. There are two input options, Name and Formula, and two selection options, Field and Items. Type a name for the calculated item and then press the Tab key to move to the formula box. Don't forget to remove 0 from the formula input. In the Items section, you can select the items for calculation. In this example, we are going to calculate the difference between two product categories, drinks and bakeware. In the Fields list, select Product Category, and in the Items list, double-click Bakeware, and then type a minus sign and double-click Drinks. Press OK. Now a new field appears in your pivot table. By inserting a calculated item, I'm essentially adding an item to my source data, but only within my pivot table. You may notice that grand total has changed. The reason behind this is, pivot table totals and subtotals include your calculated fields while the calculation of total and subtotal. So you need to filter your calculated items if you want to show the actual total value. Calculated items allow users to perform calculations within a pivot table based on existing data, providing flexibility in deriving insights and performing custom analysis. This feature is particularly useful for scenarios where direct data manipulation or additional calculations are required to meet specific analytical needs. By leveraging calculated items and calculated fields, users can unlock the full potential of Excel pivot tables, enabling more sophisticated analysis and empowering informed decision-making processes. If you found this tutorial helpful, don't forget to subscribe to my YouTube channel for more Excel tips.